Today, now, in the 21st century, there is a concerted nationwide effort to limit the right of American citizens to vote and to truly have a voice in their own government. In the wake of the November elections, one of the safest in recent history, Republican-led state legislatures have seized on the former president's big lie that the election was stolen and introduced more than 250 bills in 43 states aimed at tightening voting rules under the guise of election integrity. Instead of doing what you should be doing when you lose an election in a democracy, attempting to win over those voters in the next election, Republicans instead are trying to disenfranchise those voters. Shame on them. In Iowa, where college students often rely on the flexibility provided by early and mail-in voting, the Republican legislature voted to cut early voting by 9 days, close polls an hour earlier, and tighten rules on absentee voting. In Wisconsin, where urban and rural precincts face vastly different administrative burdens, Republicans have proposed limiting ballot drop boxes to only one municipality, no matter what its size. Could be 10,000 voters in a rural Republican county or 500,000 voters in an urban Democratic county, one ballot drop box. In Arizona, no fewer than 22 separate measures to limit voting rights have been introduced, including a bill to require every absentee ballot to be notarized. How are poor people going to pay for a notary when there's virtually no indication of fraud? It's one of the most despicable things I have seen in all my years. Shame, shame, shame. Other things in Arizona, two bills to ban automatic voter registration and same-day registration, even though neither practice exists in Arizona. And the most reprehensible effort of all might be found in Georgia, where Republicans recently passed a bill to eliminate early voting on Sunday, a day when many church-going African Americans participate in voter drives known as Souls to the Polls. What an astonishing coincidence. Outlaw voting on a day when African American churches sponsor Get Out the Vote efforts. I'd like one of the Republican members on this committee to give us a plain sense justification for that restriction. No early voting on Sundays. Why did Georgia Republicans outlaw it? Monday through Saturday, legitimate voters show up. But Sunday is voter fraud day. Give me a break. Every one of us, Democrat, Republican, liberal, and conservative, knows what the Georgia legislature is doing. They don't even have a good justification for it. This is infuriating. I would like to ask my Republican colleagues, why are you so afraid of democracy? Why, instead of trying to win voters over that you lost in the last election, are you trying to prevent them from voting? It shouldn't matter if a state wants to do it, if it's so, so wrong, so against the grain of our democracy. Voting rights are sacrosanct. They must be inviolable. And if Congress has to pass a law or amend the Constitution to protect the voting rights of our citizens, that's what we should do, that's what we must do, that's what our democracy requires we do. S1, the For the People Act, will be a priority in this Congress.
The state bills that he refers to, I believe Senator Blunt has mentioned only two of them have passed, and they had absolutely nothing to do with suppressing the vote. It's also noteworthy that this is a solution in search of a problem. The turnout in 2020 was up 7%. The turnout in the 2020 election was the highest since 1900. States are not engaging in trying to suppress voters whatsoever. This is clearly an effort by one party to rewrite the rules of our political system. But even more immediately, it would create an implementation nightmare, as Senator Blunt pointed out, that would drown state and local officials who run elections. This proposal needs all the scrutiny it can get, and I'm glad we're all here to give it that scrutiny. This legislation would forcibly rewrite the election laws of all 50 states from here in Washington. Popular policies like voter ID requirements would be banned unless states neutered them with loopholes. Meanwhile, unpopular and absurd practices like ballot harvesting, where paid political operatives can show up carrying stacks of other people's ballots, would not just be allowed, it would be mandatory. Washington would mandate that every state and county in America adopt same-day voter registration with minimal safeguards. But it would make it incredibly difficult for states and counties to conduct routine voter list maintenance, like removing dead people or voters who don't live there any longer. Then there's the whole question of political speech. Refereeing campaigns and policing speech are sensitive tasks. Appropriately, the FEC was designed after Watergate to be bipartisan, an even split, 3-3. So let me dwell on that for a minute. After Watergate, my party, the Republican Party, was just about wiped out. The overwhelming Democratic majorities could have done anything they wanted to. It never occurred to them that the Federal Election Commission, set up to police how we run campaigns, would be made a partisan entity. They could have done it then. Now we're in a 50-50 Senate and a narrowly majority in the House, and this audacious move wants to turn the judge of our democratic process into a partisan prosecutor. Talk about shame. If anybody ought to be feeling any shame around here, it's turning the FEC into a partisan prosecutor, the majority controlled by the president's party, to harass and intimidate the other side. That's what you ought to be ashamed about.
Ron, you wrote an article for CNN outlining why Republicans are so against aspects of this bill. Tell us more.
Well, look, you know, what we are seeing here, I think, in many ways, are Republicans stacking sandbags against a rising wave of demographic change across the Sun Belt in particular. If you look at states like Georgia, Texas, Arizona, Florida, South Carolina, North Carolina, the trajectory is very clear, Jake. The voters aging into the electorate who are turning 18 every year are increasingly kids of color. They're majority kids of color in most of the states that I mentioned. And the Republicans, I think, in those states are trying to cement and entrench their advantages, which are based on their strong performances among older non-college and non-urban whites, while they still have the statewide power to do so with these voter restrictions and with the gerrymandering that's coming next. And I do wonder, I was listening in my left ear to a panel at Brookings with Jeff Merkley and Amy Klobuchar, and they actually, I submitted a question this morning. I asked them, would they want to pare back the bill to deal with just the immediate emergency of what we are seeing in voter suppression in these states? They both said no, they want to go the whole hog, do the big comprehensive package. But I do wonder, given the stakes, given the magnitude of what's happening in these red states, whether Democrats at some point are going to feel the need to just focus on undoing some of these new suppression measures.
And Laura, what's your take on what's going on here?
Well, I certainly agree with Ron, which is that Republicans are trying to make moves across states, across the country to limit access to voting. I mean, that's clearly what is happening. And part of that is because of the demographic changes. I mean, young voters voted majority for Biden, and they turned out in strong numbers in states that flipped, like in Arizona and Georgia. One thing, though, is that Democrats are, it's very hard to see how they're going to pass this expansive bill because of the legislative filibuster, which I know we talk about a lot, and whether or not they're going to be able to find Republicans to get on board with a bill like this, to get 10 Republicans. And if they aren't, then this is going to run right into the filibuster and, again, is going to apply the pressure that Majority Leader Schumer wants to apply to get rid of the filibuster.
Yeah, they don't just need 10 Republicans. They also need Joe Manchin, West Virginia, who is not supportive of it right now.